There are others who would tell you the force behind what's going on today is truly the oligarchy, the crown heads of Europe, the Habsburg, the English monarchy, the Queen of the Netherlands, the King and Queen of Spain, and you remember that the latter two were part of the Club of Rome. So there seems to be almost a certain amount of incest in these various organizations. There are others who talk about the Priory of Sion, which is supposedly a secret society that traces its origins back to the Merovingian dynasties of the 5th and 6th century in southern France, outlined in a book called Holy Blood, Holy Grail, that basically says that there is a bloodline that flows through the monarchies of Europe, a royal bloodline that goes back to the House of David. Now, there are other people who say, well, the real force behind what's going on is something known as the Order of the Quest. And you may not have heard of this, but it's described in a book by Manly P. Hall entitled The Secret Destiny of America. Now, most of you may have wondered where the emblem on the back of the dollar bill came from, the pyramid capped by the all-seeing eye. Basically, it came from the back of the Great Seal of the United States. It was placed on the back of the Great Seal of the United States in 1782. And then kept there secretly, subsequently, until it was put on the back of the dollar bill in 1935 by a Masonic president at the behest of a Mason who was Henry Wallace, the Secretary of Agriculture at that time. But the understanding of the Great Seal is an understanding of the occult movement and its influence on America. Let me tell you what Manly P. Hall tells us about the Great Seal on the back, or the emblem on the back of the Great Seal of the United States. On the reverse of our nation's Great Seal is an unfinished pyramid to represent human society itself, imperfect and incomplete. Above floats the symbol of the esoteric orders, in other words, the secret orders. The radiant triangle with the all-seeing eye. There is only one possible origin for these symbols, and that is the secret societies which came to this country 150 years before the Revolutionary War. There can be no question that the Great Seal was directly inspired by these orders of the human quest and that it set forth the purpose of this nation. Now let me explain to you what he is in essence saying, is that the occult organizations, the secret societies, came to America shortly after the Pilgrims arrived in about 1620. And the purpose of America was to bring about the New World Order. They were to use America to create Novo Ordo Seclorum. And that's exactly what's happening today. The power of America is being used to force all nations into the world government. And that's what you're seeing in Kosovo, why we are simply bombing the cities, destroying everything. And if you don't give in, why, of course, that'll be a good lesson to other people. And here's Manly P. Hall, the leading occult philosopher of modern times, essentially telling you that. And the symbol on the back of the Great Seal of the United States, this is written in about 1930 or so, long before it was even put on the back of the dollar bill. The seal on the back, the mark on the back of the Great Seal symbolizes that. There are others who will tell you that the force behind what's going on in the world today is the Rosicrucians. The Rosicrucians go back to the Knights of the Rosy Cross. They have to do with the Crusades. They came to the forefront in about 1400s. They tie into Gnosticism. I've interviewed them on my radio programs. They will tell you that the Bible is all right, but what you need is the secret behind the Bible, because that will give you the power. There are others who, of course, believe that the real force behind what's going on today is the Skull and Bone Society, an occult fraternity at Yale University. The people we usually associated with would be Prescott Bush, George Bush, and, of course, his son, George Bush Jr., who may well be the next president of the United States, is a Yale graduate, and I suspect he comes from the Skull and Bone Society. This is known as America's secret establishment. In Professor Sutton's book, he goes into the background of how all of these great families tie into what is referred to as the order, the Whitney family, Phelps family, Bundy family, Lord family, Rockefellers, Harriman, Weyerhaeuser family, Sloan, Pillsbury, Davison, Payne, Gilman, Wadsworth, Taft, Perkins, Stimson. Henry Stimson was the Secretary of War during the Second World War, member of the Council on Foreign Relations, wrote a book with a man named McGeorge Bundy. McGeorge Bundy was the head of the National Security Council when we got us into the Vietnam War. The two of them got together and wrote a book entitled On Watch, and of course both of them come from the Council on Foreign Relations. There are other people who believe what's going on today is really related to theosophy. And Theosophy is a secret society that was created by Madame Blavatsky, Helena Petrovich Blavatsky, who was a Russian mystic, who organized a secret society in 1875. It has branches today in Wheaton, Illinois, headquarters, and in Ojai in California. And of course, this woman, who really did not have much of an education, wrote two of the most brilliant books. In fact, she didn't write them. They were channeled to her by a demonic spirit. One was The Secret Doctrine, the other was Isis Unveiled. And she recruited then into her organization people like Arthur Conan Doyle, who created Sherlock Holmes, William Stead, who you will hear more of shortly. Certainly her most famous disciple of the 19th century was a man named Thomas Edison, who would begin to meditate. And this is what you're taught to do when, of course, you're dealing with the occult, and come up with great ideas like the electric light, the ticker tape, the phonograph, motion pictures. All of these were things that Thomas Edison created, and we look upon him as this great genius, and he was a great genius, but he had mystical forces. He was a dedicated disciple of Madame Blavatsky. In the 20th century, of course, her best known disciples were a man named Schnickelgruber, who's also known as Adolf Hitler. And of course, he regularly read The Secret Doctrine. This is where he got his mystical force, his ability to control men, to hold crowds transfixed for hours, standing there in front of the chancellery as he would address them, and his ability to dominate and control so many people. Another very, very famous disciple of Madame Blavatsky was Margaret Sanger, who created Planned Parenthood, which is still working to getting hundreds of millions of dollars every year to push their population control eugenic programs throughout the world. Both Adolf Hitler and Margaret Sanger were dedicated to racial purity, believing that the black races and brown races and red races and yellow races were all inferior. They believed only the Anglo-Saxons were fit to rule, and they set out to exterminate them. And of course, both of them were violently anti-Semitic. And the fact that none of this is ever mentioned reflects the degree of control that today exists over what the American people think. Now, there are other people who really don't believe anything other than the unidentified flying objects, and these little critters are out there, of course, beaming their ideas down into our minds.